Hey, welcome to this session about WebSockets and Equinox OGI and Server Container. So most probably you know what OGI is and Equinox framework. Most probably you also know what does WebSocket means. I'll go quickly. So just who am I? Yeah, already know. Okay, I'm working for SAP, and in the same time I'm a project lead of a Eclipse dirigible project. So there, here I put a few links. As a context, if somebody want to learn more about what exists currently for server-side Equinox. How you can run actually Equinox in Servlet container, and what Servlet bridge means, what it looks like, and how you can use it. Also, there are several blogs by Angelo there about this. It's 6 years ago already, long time. This is a simplified diagram. So let me a little bit explain how the architecture looks like. So let's say this is the web container environment, for instance, Tomcat or Jetty. The standard approach is to have a servlet, standard servlet. You receive request, web container dispatch this to
via the alias to do the
write servlet, and it runs some actions there. So for the servlet bridge architecture, the web container receives the request, sent to a servlet bridge, which actually runs internal OGI environment, internal Equinox, which in it you can have OGI servlets, which are registered in the OGI registry. So, are you familiar with this architecture? Right?
Yeah, you know it.
Okay. So, on the other side are the web sockets. So, also you. Yeah, most probably all of you know how it works. So first we have
this handshake on open client, open WebSockets connection to the server.
And after that, we have
a full duplex communication channel. Client can send messages, in the same time server can send message to the client.
Okay, so now I'll shortly go to some focus points how we use WebSockets for our use cases in OGI, internal OGI environment. If you have questions, just interrupt me. Let's make it as a discussion, because most probably this is not just something that I present you how the things should look like or how they should be done, but this is just the way that we did it. Okay, so
the project that I created, so it's already in GitHub. I'll provide you the link. You can clone it, build it and deploy it on Tomcat just to test by yourself.
It's I isolated only the functionality that's relevant to this concept. So, first thing that we have is the extended servlet bridge. So, as you know, servlet bridge can dispatch standard servlet requests to the internal OGI servlets, but we added these bridges.
It can be done in different way, but just for simplicity, we
added these bridges map, synchronized map.
Later I'll explain why we need it. The second thing that we have in this project is a standard WebSocket servlet, which will act on this alias lock. Okay. On the OSGI side, on the Equinox side, we have this WebSocket lock bridge servlet internal,
which will be the handler, actually. So, on one hand, we have a standard WebSocket servlet. On the other hand, we have internal WebSocket handler in OSGI environment. So here the problem is how we can connect both.
The tricky part is the tricky part is that
during the activation of the plugin where the internal WebSocket servlet is,
we have a step where we create this internal servlet and register in the OSGI bridges map. So here we can register
multiple WebSocket handlers.
For sure. And this is the most the simplest way to do that. Okay, these are the steps. So the first step, as I said, during the activation, OSGI WebSocket servlet is registered to a servlet bridge or the
extended servlet bridge.
So when we receive requests
for open WebSocket
channel, it ends up here first in the standard WebSocket servlet. What this servlet WebSocket servlet does, just to look up
for the handler
in this bridge, and once it receives it, just proxy the request
to the servlet. This is how it works, simple.
So one
issue that
we had, and actually this is the way
how we fix it, is the class loading problem. So as you know, in the web container environment, we can load different classes from the leaf folders.
And hopefully
we have in the recent packaging of web containers, for instance Tomcat, Jetty, and so we have Javax WebSockets already built in,
and it's very good.
And of course, that's why we can use WebSocket servlets as a standard feature. On the other side, we have this handler, internal handler in OSGI. And if we load the same jar file, no matter that it is the same, it will be loaded with different class loader. And
so the classes from Javax WebSocket
package, for instance, will give class exceptions.
That's why we have to expose the standard packages coming which comes from web container, to expose these classes directly to the OSGI environment. This is done in the launch ini. We choose this flag here, this, for the parent class loader, we choose framework, and for the context class loader parent, framework as well. And as extra packages, we exposed, as you can see, Javax WebSocket and Javax WebSocket server. Also, we should add this package. You remember this package actually is from our sample. Oops, sorry. This one.
Where our extended servlet bridge.
Here. This content. So we expose also this package.
In this way,
the same class will be
exposed to the OSGI class loaders as well. And it's the same. That's why we can have this static map
in the extended servlet bridge.
And we can use from the web container environment and from the OSGI environment.
So this is the trick here.
Okay.
So a little bit
more complicated it becomes when it
comes for the authentication and authorization.
So WebSockets,
usually we don't have a
synchronous request
there, but there is a possibility with this server endpoint configurator
in the container web container environment,
we can
hook when the standard requests
go through and register this in the security context. Afterwards, we can
in the OSGI
side, we can take this handshake request from the session user properties to get it
and to use is user in role, for instance, in the
WebSocket body.
Okay, so let's
go to the demo.
If you have some questions or something is not clear, or you have other ideas how it should be.
So first of all, we clone the project. I already cloned. We can build and deploy and
run the server. Let me see. So, I hear it. Let me stop it and run it again.
So it's standard config.
Okay.
After the build and deploy, this is the folder structure, how it looks like. We have webinf, we have configuration folder,
you know what it is most probably.
Here is the config ini where all the plugins in Linux listed should be started. We have this lib folder where our OSGI WebSocket stuff is packed. Here, OSGI WebSocket bridge. We have all the plugins
which live in the OSGI environment after the start. Okay. So let me explain a little bit what the demo should show. So
this one is our extended servlet bridge, a bridge servlet with this bridges collection. So it's not a collection but hash map. Yeah.
and also this standard WebSocket servlet, which is this alias log. Okay, this is for the open connection.
Okay. So on the other side, let me start with this standard servlet. So we will have one standard OGS servlet. Which will do the following: when we access it, it will take the internal WebSocket and will log a message, hello from OSGI. It is quite simple. This is the activator. As you see, we have during the start of the plugin, we set up this log channel here. And at the end, the internal WebSocket, what it does, it has this log method, which will go through all the open sessions and will send a simple text message which comes from this standard servlet. It's quite a simple thing. Okay. Let's go to the demo. So, okay. First of all, I have this standard servlet. I access it. It establishes this security context. Here I create a new WebSocket which goes to this log alias. Okay, here I can inspect the frames. Here all the messages that will come. Okay. And from a second browser, I'll access again this standard servlet, and it actually writes a log in the internal WebSocket, which actually sends this log to all the connected sessions, WebSocket sessions. So we can do also the following. Can open another one. Okay, and when we access here, as you see, it sends a message to all the clients. Okay, so this means that you already can use WebSocket, for instance, to create chat applications or more complex stuff using OSGI servlet container. Let me show
some real world examples
where we use for what reason we did all this.
First of all, we wanted to have responsive web log console.
So when something happens on the server side, we want to receive this.
Just
to let you know that the dirigible core part is based on OSGI, So it's OSGI application, which is built as a WAR file, and it can be deployed as a WAR file on Servlet container. That's why we have this problem.
And to be able to use, to be able to have such a log console,
we needed WebSocket because of the bidirectional communication.
The another thing we need it also for such kinds of things,
for the terminal console.
We establish, we have a terminal client which connects to WebSocket terminal server servlet. We also use for
our debug perspective.
So this part here, I don't know whether you recognize it, but it's almost entire, okay.
Partially, it's RAP, so it's RCP in the browser. You know what is RAP, right? Eclipse RAP.
But, okay, this part here is
Orion.
And this part here is a
web, again, web view, which connects with WebSocket servlet.
This is actually a debug session. And you can click here to go through the lines, and
it's very responsive, like a live debugger.
Another thing that we use WebSockets is to be able to implement
WebSocket scripting services. So in Eclipse Dirigible, you can implement your own
scripting and make it
available and exposed as WebSocket. And it's very,
very easy.
Okay, let me show. Do I have time?
10 minutes, okay.
Okay, this is Dirigible, let me reload. Actually, this is the trial instance, which actually is deployed on Canada server in Eclipse.org. So this is the local zone. And let's say this is my test service. Okay. What it does, it prints in the console some info here. And when I trigger it, as you see, it's quite responsive. So it's immediately appears in the log. Another thing is this terminal, where you can have pipes. Okay. Let me try to show also the debugger. I think we will have time for that. So
the screen is very small.
Try to do this. Okay.
Yes, you see, it goes through the lines.
This actually goes through the required module response. Yesterday, no, the day before yesterday, we had session for enterprise JavaScript. So this response is
actually the module from this.
We can have
breakpoint. As you see, we stopped this this breakpoint, so we can expect the values, and so. Okay, C is undefined. We can go one line further, and and so on. Okay, yeah. Anyway, this is just some examples from our project. Okay, let's go again to the presentation. So, okay, what you want now is that there is a possibility currently, even in the current state of the framework, to utilize WebSockets. You know already how we made it, what we use it, whether it's the perfect one, probably could be implemented in different way, but as far as I know, there is no other as of now. You learned that it's used already in real world. Okay, or JS cool, it's for sure. And yeah, you can go to dirigible.io to try it. So, a little bit of the time. Okay. Thank you.